This video is designed to be a guide. Please note that other complications may exist that aren't addressed in this guide. While we always strive to provide accurate and detailed information, we can't guarantee that it will fix your TV's issues. Shop Jimmy is not responsible for any harm that you may cause to yourself or damage to your TV during the repair process. Try all repairs and troubleshooting at your own risk. Be sure to take all the proper safety precautions. In this video, we will give a tutorial on how to solder. We will use various components to show how to remove them from a board and then solder a replacement to the board. The first component we are going to show how to replace is a capacitor. A capacitor can also be referred to as a cap. I will start by identifying the cap that we are going to replace on the front side of the board. Then I will flip the board over and find the solder points on the back. Use your desolder tool or soldering iron to desolder the component from the board. Once you have removed the solder, the component may fall off the board. If not, you can flip the board over and then pull the component out. Take your replacement cap and align it correctly on the board. Line up the striped side of the cap with the striped side on the board. Slide the legs of the cap through the holes in the board. You can keep one hand on the front side of the board and use the other hand to slightly bend the legs to hold the component in place on the back side. Use your iron in one hand and solder in the other. Place the iron tip on the bottom of the leg and the pad on the board. Then touch the solder to the iron and slide the iron tip up the leg and away from the pad and leg. Here are some photos of some solder joints from multiple angles. Here is what the solder joints should not look like. Here's what the solder joints should look like. After you have soldered the legs to the board, you can use a side clippers to trim the legs close to the board. Then use some isopropyl alcohol and a brush to clean up the area on the board. The next component we are going to replace is a MOSFET. This can also be referred to as a FET. This FET is screwed into the heatsink and soldered to the board. The first thing we are going to do is remove the screw. Then I will flip the board over and desolder the component. After I have removed the existing FET, I will take my replacement and use my tweezers to bend the legs so they can fit through the holes in the board. Then I will apply some heatsink compound, also known as thermal paste, to the back of the FET. Then get the FET into position on the board. Screw the FET to the heatsink. Flip the board over and solder the legs. Trim the legs and clean up the area using isopropyl alcohol and a brush. The next component we are going to replace is this IC. I will start by adding solder to the legs on both sides of the chip. Then I will run my iron over the legs to heat up the solder and loosen the chip from the board. I will remove it with my tweezers. We accidentally got some solder on another part of the board while removing this IC. I will use my solder wick and iron to clean it up. I will use my solder wick and iron to clean up the pads underneath the IC. Then I will use isopropyl alcohol and the brush to clean up the pads. Get the replacement IC correctly aligned on the board. Pin 1 on the chip shows a dot, and that dot should be placed in the corner as shown on the board. Once the chip is aligned, place the tweezers on top of it to hold it securely to the board, and then run the flux pen over the legs. While still holding it in place with the tweezers, extend some of the solder on your roll. Then touch the iron to the solder to get a little bit on the iron, and then run the tip of the iron over the legs of the IC. This will solder it to the board. Be sure there are no solder bridges. This is an image of what a solder bridge looks like. Once the first side is done, you can remove the tweezers and apply some flux to the other side. Then, once again, get some solder on the iron and run it over the legs. Use the brush and isopropyl alcohol to clean up the area on the board. The next component we are going to show how to replace is a resistor. Alternate the soldering iron on both sides of the resistor until it has loosened from the board. After removing the component, clean up the pads with solder wick and the iron. Then use the isopropyl alcohol and a brush to clean it up. Add solder to one of the pads. Use the tweezers in one hand to place the component while using the iron in the other hand to heat up and loosen the solder. Then use the iron and add solder to the other side to secure the component to the board. Use the isopropyl alcohol and a brush to clean up the area. The next component is an optocoupler that we will show how to replace. Start on the back side of the board, and I will use a desolder tool to remove the solder and loosen the component from the board. You could also use a soldering iron and solder wick to desolder the component. Once again, the component may fall out of the board. If it does not, use the tweezers to remove it. Once again, line up pin 1 on the component with pin 1 on the board. get the component into position, and push the legs through the board. Hold the component tight against the board with a finger on the front side. Then, bend a few of the legs to help keep the component in place. Use the solder and iron to solder the legs to the board. Use isopropyl alcohol and a brush to clean up the area.